là, on va être sur l'île. Une positive caractéristique.
C'est pour ça que vous avez déjà des idées. Sur le plan, sur state class formula ou class number formula, vous avez une positive caractéristique pour toute chaque phase. Donc, il y a une chose et une analogie avec le classical et le class number formula. Donc, vous tous connaissez this classical power of zero nul. And today we are interested in this one. So our base ring will be the ring of polynomial in one determinants over F2. This is by L. And we take the same construction. So K will be the function field. We take the completion with the infinite trace. So this is the Lorentz series in 1 over theta. And like as for the periodic case for two, we need to take the completion of an algebraic closure of k infinity to obtain an algebraic closure on complete field. In particular, we can mark that A is discrete and co-compact in k infinity. And if you think of the class number formula, it's the class group. And, we take the cardinality of the class group. And here, since the base ring is L and Z, we are interested in the fitting idea of a class of a I module. So if A, if B is a finite A module, so by finite, I just want to say that it's finitely generative on the of torsion. We can consider the fitting ideal of B as a module, so by the Tuchok theorem, and instead of deal with the ideal, we need to take a monic generator of this ideal. So we denote by the bracket A the unique monic generator.
Can you please remind what fitting idea was?
Fitting idea, if we take B a finite n module, since A is a principal by the Strucher theorem, B is isomorphic to some product of cyclic group. And so the fitting of B as A module is ideal. Generated by the product of Fi, so like for the cardinality. So bracket B will be the monic generator, so the product of Fi are monics. So in particular, in the class formula, there will be a bracket of the certain class module. So in this case, we have the classical Riemann zeta function. And for us, Karlitz in the 30s introduced what we now call the zeta Karlitz function, Karlitz zeta function. So it's defined for a positive integer n as the sum of the nth power of monic polynomial, so a plus the set. As a positive integer. And in particular, for n equal to 1, this converges. So in the class formula, we don't need some residue or limit or something like that. The convergence, okay. And as for the Riemann zeta function, since A is the ring A is a factorial, we have an Eulerian product, P prime. So prime of A, it's an irreducible and monic polynomial. As usual. And we use this product to. It's an important thing to have this product. So the first step for the. To have the class formula is to make a link between z a new structure of any module.
This converges in which way?
In K infinity. So if B is an A algebra, we can consider C of B, which is just B as a F cube vector space. But the action of A is different from the classical left multiplication. So the Hamiltonian structure is given by what we call the Karpitz model. So for example, F is a prism of B, and the action of theta is theta plus tau. Tau, where tau is a formulus, so the Q power map over B. So it's something like a twist action. So usually we have just the left multiplication by theta, and here we have an action of the Frobenius. And if we have an A algebra, we have two structures, the usual one and the Karpitz one. For example, if you take x in C infinity, C theta of x, the action of theta, is just theta x plus x to the cube. Twisted action. Or in particular, we can compute some fitting for these two structure of module. So if we take P a prime, by definition, the fitting of A over PA is P, the definition. And it's easy to show that with the Karpitz action, the fitting is given by P minus 1. So, fitting is very easy. But in particular, using these two results, we can express the value of the Karpitz zeta function in 1, so we find that theta of 1 is the product over prime of the fitting of A over PA the same with the action of the Karpitz module. And this is the first step to for the class formula. So we have this for n equal to 1. We want this for all n. So this for n. So so this result is from the 30s, when suddenly in the 90s by Anderson and Takur. What we call the nth tensor product of the Karpitz module, C to the n. And in fact, it's a construction like this. If B is an A algebra, we can consider Cn of B, it's B to the n as a cubic vector space. We have an action of A given by something with a Frobenius. So it's so the action of theta is given by the constant term is the matrix with theta in the diagonal 1 over on 0 elsewhere, plus a term in tau, where just the matrix is the one in the top, the bottom left corner, tau. So this gives an action of B to the n, and we have Anderson in 86 introduced a category of T-modules in which C to the N, this one, is the tensor product of C. So we have this action. So for example, if for a vector in C infinity to the N, the action of C to the N of theta of a column vector x1 xn, just the multiplication by theta plus for the n minus 1 first coordinate, just that on the last one, we have two actions on the first component. I denote this matrix by d theta. It's d because we can consider a tangent action, which is given by we just take tau equal to zero, so we just have this action of this matrix. And in fact, the Karitz module on the n tensor of Karitz module are just particular case of Drüsselfeld module or T module. So in fact, the Drüsselfeld module is this in dimension 1, so is n equal to 1, and it's given by a polynomial of any degree in tau. The only one condition is to have theta in a constant term. And T module is the same thing, we have a polynomial of any degree in tau, and the first coefficient must be d theta. To such a T module or Anderson module, we can associate an exponential map.
So, can you regard C tensor N as a Drüsselfeld module?
No, it's not a it's a Drüsselfeld module only for n equal to 1. We need to have a...
And when n is not 1, then it's not...
It's not a Drüsselfeld module, but it's not a Drüsselfeld module, but a T module is a generalization of a Drüsselfeld module. So to such a Anderson module, we can associate an exponential map, which is given by a power theory in tau, with coefficient in our matrices of k, on we have two conditions. So the first term is the identity matrix. And we have a composition rule. So the exponential of the with the left multiplication by d theta, the exponential maps the left multiplication by d theta to the action of the Karitz module. So this is an equality of formal power theory in tau, but it's easy to show that the exponential converges on C infinity to the n. So we get a homomorphism. So the exponential, the tangent space. So this space is C infinity to the n as a FQ vector space, and the action of A is given by theta map on left multiplication by d theta. So it's just to take tau equal to zero on this mass into the structure of the Karitz module. And this is a homomorphism of A algebra. The action of tau on a column vector is just takes the two power map on each component. So we have this exponential map, and we have as for the case in equal to 1, two structures of A module, so
see the action of the Karlitz module like as an analog of the multiplicative group. So the multiplicative group, the number, if you take a finite field, that is the number of elements of GM of F, or F finite field is the number of elements of F minus 1. So it's something like that, a minus 1. So with these two equality, we have we can write the beta value in N as for N equal to 1 as a product of PT. The first step for the class formula, because now this zeta values are fitting, and fitting can be viewed as the characteristic polynomial of the action of theta and the space. So we can express this as a determinant, because KM idea for the proof. More thing before to state the class formula. So you can consider two space, so the tangent space in L, so just the column vector in L is the action of the matrix d theta. And you can also look at the inverse image by the exponential of integral points. So these two ones are in fact lattices of tangent space in K infinity. My lattices are just discrete and co-compact submodule. And, so for A is very easy because A is co-compact in K infinity, so it's the same thing for the column vector. And for exponential is not very hard to show this. And, so we have two lattices. On our class formula we need a class module, so it's defined as this. So the class module associated to A on C to the N is something like the defect of surjectivity of the exponential map. So it's the space K infinity, C infinity, K infinity, quotiented by the image of the exponential map. And by the integral points. So the result is this module is a finite A module. So in particular, we can take the fitting for the bracket A for a generator. And this is called the class module. So this was defined by Minit Hellman. When he showed, he explained why he called this a class module. In fact, he defined a class module and also a unit module, and they share a lot of property with the classical one in the number of case. So we should.
Excuse me, what does the last argument say?
What?
To the.
For the question?
Yeah, here.
Yes, it's C to the N of A.
Of A. Okay.
So, there is the last thing to define before to state the bracket of M1, M2 in L as a, the unique, the monic representative of the determinant. Like we, if we need to choose a basis, we have a define a modulo an element of FQ, so choose the monic representative. So I can state the class formula. So the class formula was originally proved by Lenny Telman 2 years ago for the case n equal to 1, and it was generalized at the beginning of the year by Jiang Sun Fong for any n. So you have the zeta value at n, we show that it is a product of fitting. Bracket of the two lattices times the fitting of the finite element of the class module. So we have something like zeta value, which is the formula, is equal to something times the fitting of the class module, and this is called a regulator by analogy. And it's also a regulator because the reciprocal event by exponential is not. So it's something like a determinant of logarithm of some units, so like in the number of field case. And in fact,
you have determinant of sigma is an element of K infinity.
Yes, it's an inequality in K infinity.
What do you mean by monic representative?
Because we need to is defined up to an element of FQ because of the choice of a basis. So we take the multiply by the inverse of the leading coefficient of the determinant. So
it is still a power series.
Yes, it's power series of K infinity. It's an equality in K infinity. Theory of Fredholm operator on infinite determinants, and the generalization by Fong use the theory of Stukas, well pronounced in Russian world, but Stukas on the ideas of Vincent Laforgue, and it seems very complicated for the Fong proof to be generalized. I don't know what is the argument, but...
I don't understand the statement of the theorem. This first equality is by Kelvin, or the...
Theory. This?
Yes.
It's just the computation of the fitting.
That's just computation.
In fact, the statement is more general. For Telman, it's for any Dreyfus module. And for Fong, it's for any T module.
Rank one.
Any rank. But... that is interesting only in this case because we, in other case, we can't compute the fitting, so we don't know it's, if it's an interesting L value. Just a quotient of fitting is equal to this, but we don't recognize some zeta value already introduced in the theory.
So their theorem is the second equality?
The second equality is the theorem.
Okay.
Here is just not only in A, it's the integral closure and some function field, an extension of K. So, like for the class formula, the case in A is not the more interesting one. It's like for zeta, if we take the class formula for Q, it doesn't tell a lot of interesting, it's not an interesting statement, but this is also okay for integral closure in some extension, finite extension. So my work was to generalize that, this. So, what's the, so, so we just take, so note the, here the base field is always the FQ, when we take Q of theta and so on. So I take some indeterminates over C infinity. Infinity. For instead to be an FQ, we consider as a base field K of S, which are the rational function in T1 Ts. So A becomes RS, so it's just the polynomial in one indeterminate over Ks. Or in particular, it's still a principal ideal domain. So it's okay to define fitting on this ring on the K infinity, just yes infinity, the Lorentz series in 1 over theta over Ks. So just some notation on the so we can state that it's right. If we take FT, the T module, so T module is just something like C to the n, is we can see like a polynomial of in tau of any degree with coefficient or matrices of in the K infinity. So we take a T module, so we have that. The special value associated to this T module is defined as the product of primes of A. So now we have we take fitting in RS. So here the notation are the same. It's the action given by E on the action given by just d theta, constant term of the polynomial depending on E on this convergence that trivial here. So we just need to there is the same proof as in Telman, the determinant of Fredholm operator, but we need to modify some technical one because the bias field is not finite, so there is a lot of minor modification, but it's not very hard, just technical points. On the interest of this generalization with TIs, is we can use this TI to if we have convergence, we can evaluate now in choosing a value for TI. And with this technique, we prove that this class formula is not only for the zeta value, like zeta k, but for other L-series. So for the end of the talk, I will speak about two examples of L-series
So just to think, this is a general relation. If we take S equal to 0, this is a reduced platform. So the first example is a Taylor ring, Taylor ring, L value. So there are a new kind of L values because they were defined in 2 years ago by Taylor ring. So we have the Ti, and we consider chi of Ti as the map of where we, for a polynomial, we evaluate it in Ti. So it's just like a change of variables. And in fact, for Taylor ring, it's a more general statement. We don't need some indeterminacy. We can take, for example, an element in the algebraic closure of F, something like this, that's an evaluation. And so the L value in N, so N positive integer, is chi t1 chi ts, is the sum over I plus, so the monic elements, of chi t1, the product of the evaluation, a to the n. So for example, TIs can be almost everything. We don't just need to look at the convergence of the series. But for example, if we take s equal to 1 and Ti is theta, and then chi theta is just zeta a of n minus 1. In particular, we have the zeta value, but it's much more general. We have a lot of freedom for Ti. And the goal to apply the class formula to such L series is to find the good T-module, and conclude the two fitting and recognize the L value. So for this, we take let alpha be T1 minus theta, the product of Ti minus theta, and we consider the T modules of rank 1, T alpha, defined by
Now A is back to FQT.
Yes, we back. It's we take E module on FQT, F to theta.
This term also?
What?
This for this term?
We use this theorem in a special case of one special E. We choose an E. In fact, we just choose an E, do the computation of this, and recognize the Taylor-Ritz value. So we choose, this one is defined by, so the first term is always d theta, and the other, just like for the next tensor product of the Kais module, but instead to have one here, we have this element, alpha, and we can show that for P of prime of A, the fitting alpha of A over PA is P to the N minus the product of the evaluation of P at the TIs. So in particular, for the tangent space is always P to the N. So we obtain that this value, this L value, so L P alpha over RS, is the product over P to the N over this. So we recognize that is the sum over A plus
result for n equal to 1 was used by Bruno Anglès, Federico Pellerin, and Toric Tavares Melero to obtain some arithmetic information on this L value, using the class formula, to obtain some integral integrability result of the L value. In fact, they are related to some, in his original paper, Pellerin linked this L value to some Drinfeld modular forms. So there is a link on the, with the class formula, they obtain some arithmetical information for the L value. So this was the first example. And the second one is for Gauss L value. So Gauss L values are ordered, we are defined in the 17, I think. And something like the it's the analog for function field of SI. So I recall k is fq of theta, and we consider L the finite extension of k generated by the torsion of the Karis module. So I need to fix a polynomial, a monic polynomial square free. There is the extension generated by the high torsion of the Karis module of C. In fact, C is a new structure of high module. You can compute the torsion in the algebraic closure of K. And we consider this extension. And this is called the Hayes cyclotomic field. Because it shares a lot of properties with a classical cyclotomic field. For example, can define lambda of L as the exponential of Pitted over A. So I need to define Pitted. Pitted is just the generator of the kernel of the exponential. So we can show this is a free high module of rank 1. We have a generator, this is pi-kid, with the analog of 2 I pi. And we can take this element, it's something like the root of unity, and this is a generator of the attraction. In particular, L is the expression generated by lambda A, and we can show that the integral closure is the polynomial in the lambda A. So it's something like the cyclotomic field, usual cyclotomic field. And we can see the analogy also on the Galois group. So if we denote by delta A the Galois group of L over K, we can show this is isomorphic to invertible element of L over L. So like for the classical case. So on, we can describe the isomorphism. So to such a B we have sigma B, and we just need to give the action on the lambda A. By sigma B of lambda A is the Karis action of B and lambda A. So with the exponential of the remember the just exponential C of B by Q over A. Just the multiplication of two in the exponential. So I said that both L values are analogs of Dirichlet ones, so I need some character. So you take a character of delta L, so just a FQ linear homomorphism from delta A into the closure of FQ. To such a character, we can associate a pointer. So I don't define this, but it depends on the. We need to decompose A in product of prime. And we look at the decomposition of chi in the product of a Tetschmuller character associated to prime. And so we will consider a primitive character. So we have the conductor. So for L a positive integer, the both L value associated to this character is defined as for the classical case, the sum of our Monic elements K of sigma B over B to the L, where we define the chi of sigma B equal to zero if B is not prime to the conductor. So for example, for the trivial character, you have the zeta value. As we divide by the cardinality of delta A, we need the assumption that A is square free. If A is not square free, then we can't define this EKI. So this is an element of the group algebra over K infinity, non-zero element. With this L value, we can prove an equivariant class formula. So it was originally proved by Bruno Anders and Lenny Tellman 2 years ago for n equal to 1. On a generalized this for any n. And so we ln of delta A is equal to, as for the first one, a bracket of lattices on a class module. So it's for C to the N. So A is the integral closure of A in L. It's inverse image of the exponential. So we take elements in A of delta A times a fitting of the class module. As A of delta A module. So this is principal, so it's okay for fittings. And to define this bracket, we need to look at all isotopical components. We do as usual with the determinant, and we group together in one value like this. And in fact, this equivalent class formula is not directly a corollary of the first one. We need to look at all isotopical components. And in fact, the action of the Kalitz module is mapped on several T modules of rank 1 with a parameter depending on the chi. And we need the class formula for this all isotopical components, and after we can group them together. And this forks. There is an analog of the conjecture on the Van der Waals conjecture on the Maxwell body, and they show that this is false. So I hope to tell with this pseudo-Lucas formula arithmetic information for the value in test.
We consider the infinity of the polynomial, this one, and we have a variation on this, taking the infinimum of, if we expand this, as a polynomial in Ti, this polynomial. We define the variation of this. This is the variation. The minimum of the variation of alpha I. The variation of this is this. And we take the completion. So it's something like the power series with the coefficient, the limit of coefficient is zero. So it's okay for the convergence.
Another question? Jean-Bert, could you explain again? Why do you need a square, a to be square free? You just, I missed something.
Because if so I, it's yeah. One over the cardinality of delta I. Of this
yes. But
the cardinality of...
Delta I is divisible by P?
No, it's if A is square free, it's not divisible by P. It's, if we need, if we just take A equal to P, mm-hmm. The cardinality of delta A is Q to the degree of P mm-hmm. minus 1.
Yes, and A equals P square?
A equals P square, we have something like this. Is it.
Oh, okay.
So we don't consider that. So we need a new idea to take the equivalent formula if A is not square. All the proof is.